Hey guys, welcome back to Tech Non Tech TV. In this video, we'll learn about DCL commands and also I'll show you how to create new user in Oracle 11j. So let's understand what is DCL command first. Data control language is used to control privileges in database. To perform any operation in database, such as for creating tables, sequences, or views, a user needs privileges. Privileges are of two types, system and objects. System includes permission for creating session, table, etc. and all types of other system privileges. Object includes permissions for any command or query to perform any operation on the database tables. So in DCL, we have two commands, grant and revoke. Grant used to provide any user access privileges or other privileges for the database. So we can follow this syntax to perform grant query. Here privilege name is the access right or privilege granted to the user. Some of the access rights are all execute and select. Here object name is the name of an database object like table, view, procedure and sequence. And username is the name of the user to whom an access right is being granted. And public is used to grant access rights to all users. And here roles are a set of privileges grouped together. And the last is with grant option, which allows a user to grant access rights to other users. Next we have revoke command. Revoke command is used to remove the permissions or privileges of a user on database objects set by the grant command. So once you have granted privileges, you may need to revoke some or all the privileges. To do this, you can run a revoke command. So to perform a revoke command, we have to follow this syntax. So let's see how to grant and revoke access to any user in Oracle 11j. So first I'll show you how to create user in database. So if you are using SysDBA user, then you may get some errors. For example, if you want to drop some table in Sys user, then you will get this error. To maintain the integrity of data dictionary, tables in the Sys schema are manipulated only by the database. They should never be modified by any user or database administrator. You must not create any tables in the Sys schema. So it's better to create your own user in the database. So first let's see how to create new user. So here we have to write create user, then we have to mention our username. Then we have to write identified by, and here we'll mention our password for the username. So always remember your username and password. So we have successfully created user ABC. Now let's see how to grant permission to user. So here first we are giving connect to privilege to user ABC. Basically grant connect grants the user permissions to connect to SQL server. Without connect to privilege, it won't allow the user to log in into the database. Next, we'll use resource with grant command. The resource role grant a user the privileges necessary to create procedure triggers in Oracle 11j. Granting a user resource without connect doesn't allow the user to log in into the database. Now this command grants a select permission on employee table to user TechNonTechTV. You should use the with grant option carefully because, for example, if you grant select privilege on employee table to the user TechNonTechTV using the with grant option, then user 2 can grant select privilege on employee table to another user, such as user XYZ. Later, if you revoke the select privilege on employee from user TechNonTechTV, still user XYZ will have a select privilege on employee table. So now let's see revoke command. Revoke select on employee from TechNonTechTV. This command will revoke a select privilege on employee table from user TechnonTechTV. When you revoke select privilege on a table from a user, then user will not be able to select data from that table anymore. However, if the user has received select privileges on that table from more than one user, then he and she can select from that table until everyone who granted the permission revokes it. You cannot revoke privileges if they were not initially granted by you. So here we have successfully revoked select privilege from the user TechnonTechTV. Now open another window and let's check if we are able to log in with the user that we have created in the beginning. So here we can see we have connected to our newly created user ABC. So that's it for this video. If you understand this video, then please share your valuable feedback in the comment section. And in the next video, I will explain TCL command. So stay tuned.